and welcome to Newsclick. I am Anusha Paul and we are bringing you a glimpse of some of the most important but not so trending stories we report at Newsclick. The National Investigation Agency, NIA, on Wednesday detained 10 people, including an alleged group leader of a newly traced Islamic State module, Harkat-ul-Harb-e-Islam, that was reportedly planning attacks in North India, especially in Delhi. Following raids conducted in 16 places in Delhi and Uttar Pradesh, searches were conducted in Lucknow, Simhauli, Saidpur Ima village, Islam Nagar, Shahi Chaturba, etc. The official source said that one of the alleged module head, Suhail, was detained with one pistol and explosive material from Amroha. Raids were conducted at the Saidpur Ima village from where the NIA picked up three siblings, Idris, Nafis and Anis, son of Shahid Ahmed, who owns a welding shop at Dhanora Adda. IANS reported that, according to NIA source, the three brothers were being questioned. They were being monitored by the anti-terror probe agency for the past 3 months after the sale of a pistol to an alleged terrorist Jamshed by the students of DNS College in New Delhi. The agency said it also recovered one pistol and a grenade launcher besides the jihadi literature. The NIA source said that the questioning of those nabbed would reveal vital information about the module, their plans and the handlers. Demanding an immediate curb on the illegal land acquisition for the proposed Adani Power Plant in Goda district of the BJP ruled state, the Jharkhand Jan Adhikar Mahasabha, that's JJM, an umbrella network of more than 30 people's organization, has submitted a representation alongside a fact-finding report to the state governor, Draupadi Murmu. In February 2016, Adani Power, a subsidiary of Adani Group, proposed setting up of a 1600 megawatt coal-fired power station in Goda district. As per the proposal, all the power generated will be exported to Bangladesh. According to the fact-finding report by the JJM, at the end of October this year, nearly 500 acres of land have already been acquired from the four villages, in spite of the resistance from the villagers. Over 40 families have been affected by this illegal acquisition of land, as per the report. The project is being set up by grossly violating various laws and rules. Tribal and poor farmers are being harassed and their lands as well as livelihood is being taken away in contravention of the law. Adani Group has adopted a series of manipulations and misrepresentation to subvert legal process, the report had stated. As per the social impact evaluation report of the Adani company, about 1,363.15 acres of land is proposed to be acquired from 10 villages of Goda and Prayahad blocks to set up 2 units of power plant with an investment of 15,000 crore. The Jharkhand government has categorized this power plant under the public project category. Coal will be imported for this project from Australia and the generator electricity will be sold to Bangladesh. People of Goda and Jharkhand are not going to benefit in any way from this project. Hence, categorizing this project as a public project is a gross violation of the provisions of the Land Acquisition Act. The tribals have been threatened with the dire consequences and the false cases even as their traditional burial grounds have been demolished. Tube wells used for irrigating crops have been damaged and hundreds of trees which were the sources of livelihood for the tribals have also been uprooted. Yet the government is silent. Under the banner of United Forum of Bank Unions, an umbrella body of the top 9 bank unions, more than 10 lakh bank employees have given the call for a one-day strike on December 26th. Protesting against the proposed merger of Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank with the Bank of Baroda. The merger of the state-owned banks Vijaya Bank and Dena Bank, both which are under the Prompt Corrective Action PCA, framework of the Reserve Bank of India with the larger peer Bank of Baroda was announced by the government in September 2018. This merger would make Bank of Baroda the third largest lender in the country, next to the State Bank of India and ICICI Bank. The unions have said that the merger of the banks will lead into the closing of a large number of branches and the customers will have to face hardships. They have said in a statement that the banks are already burdened with the various government schemes like Jan Dhan Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Housing Scheme, Mudra and the likes. C.H. Venkatachalam, General Secretary of All India Bank Employees Association, said that the mergers will surely result in a closure of branches, whereas we need branch expansion to make the banking accessible to all. The number of the banks in US for a population of 323 million is far more than the number of banks in India for a population of 1.35 billion. So India is not overbanked. Hence, there is no need for consolidation. A combined NPAs or bad loans of Bank of Baroda, Dena Bank and Vijaya Bank will add up to 80,000 crore. Now the question is whether these bad loans will be automatically recovered when these banks are merged. On December 18, Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador announced government's deal with the Swiss transnational food and beverage company Nestle to build a $154 million worth coffee processing plant in Veracruz, Mexico. Following the announcement, small coffee farmers and several peasants organizations of the Mexico rejected Nestle's plan, claiming that it will not benefit the small producers and will harm the environment. President AMLO, after meeting with Foster Costa, the CEO of Nestle Mexico, announced that the plant would process some 20,000 tons of green coffee per year and would generate employment opportunities in the region. Costa at the same time said that the project would prove to be economically beneficial to not only to those employed but to the entire southeast region of the country where the majority of high-quality Mexican coffee is grown. Highlighting the exploitative practices of the multinational, Silo Lothan, the president of the Regional Council of the Coffee in Coatepec, said that the Nestle has always controlled the prices of coffee and have exploited the coffee producers, not just in Mexico, but at a global level for decades. At a press conference held on December 19, members of the plan of Ayala National Coordinator, an organization that projects farmers' rights, also rejected the plan and said that the government should have consulted the coffee farmers of Mexico before reaching to an agreement with Nestle. They also said that any initiative taken by the government should benefit its people rather than any multinational company. The project is another step taken by the government that will add the agony of Mexico's coffee producers. As earlier this month, the federal government presented the 2019 budget in which it cut funding for Mexico's coffee sector by more than 50%. That's all we have for you in today's episode of Daily Roundup. To keep yourself updated, just log on to www.newsclick.in. Also, you can follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel.